الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلق الله أجمعين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Have you ever heard about the Messiah Dajjal? Who is the Dajjal? How was the Dajjal described? What is the meaning of Dajjal? Who was the Sahaba that met the Dajjal? Who will kill the Dajjal, and how do we all protect ourselves from the Dajjal? Today, inshallah, we will be discussing about the Messiah Dajjal in this video. The Dajjal is an evil figure in Islam who will come before the Day of Judgment and pretend to be the promised Messiah and later claim to be Allah, which of course isn't true. And because he will start claiming to be Allah, he will bring with him something like Jannah and Jahannam. But what he calls Jannah will be in fact Jahannam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the Dajjal being blind in one eye, and on his forehead will be written the word Kafir, which any Muslim will be able to read. And the meaning of Dajjal means the one-eyed liar. And at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a Sahaba called Tamim al-Dari that met the Dajjal. There is a very long hadith that tells a story. عن فاطمة بنت قيس رضي الله عنها قالت سمعت نداء المنادي منادي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينادي الصلاة جامعة، فخرجت إلى المسجد فصليت مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فكنت في صف النساء التي تلي ظهور القوم، فلما قضى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاته جلس على المنبر وهو يضحك فقال ليلزم كل إنسان مسلاه، ثم قال أتدرون لما جمعتكم؟ قالوا الله ورسوله أعلم. It was narrated that Fatima binti Qais, may Allah be pleased with her, said, I heard the voice of the caller of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, As-salatu jami'ah. Salah is about to begin. So I went out to the masjid and I prayed with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I was in the woman's row that was closest to the Prophet. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had finished his salah, he sat on the minbar and he was smiling. He said, let each person stay in the place where he just prayed. Then he said, do you know why I called you together? They said, Allah and his Messenger know best. The Prophet said, إني والله ما جمعتكم لرهبة ولا لرهبة ولكن جمعتكم لأن تميما الداري كان رجلا نصرانيا فجاء فبايع وأسلم وحدثني حديثا وافق الذي كنت أحدثكم عن مسيح الدجال حدثني أنه ركب في سفينة بحرية مع 30 رجلا من لخم وجذام فلعب بهم الموج شهرا في البحر ثم فأرفعوا إلى جزيرة في البحر حتى مغرب الشمس فجلسوا في أقرب السفينة فدخلوا الجزيرة فلقيتهم دابة أهلب كثير الشعر لا يدرون ما قبله من دبره من كثرة الشعر فقالوا ويلك ما أنت By Allah, I did not call you together for an exhortation or for a warning. I have called you together because Tamim al-Dari was a Christian and he came and pledged allegiance and converted to Islam and told me something which agrees with what I was telling you about the Dajjal. He told me that he sailed in a ship with 30 men from Nukam and Judam, which are two Arab tribes, and they were tossed by the waves of the sea for a month. Then they came to an island at sunset. They sat in a small rowing boat and landed on the island. They were met by a beast with a great deal of hair, and they could not distinguish his face from his back because he was so hairy. They said, Woe to you! What are you? فقالت أنا الجساسة قالوا وما الجساسة قالت أيها القوم انطلقوا إلى هذا الرجل في الدير فإنه إلى قبركم بالأشواق قال لما سمت لنا رجلا فرقنا منها أن تكون شيطانة قال فانطلقنا سراعا حتى دخلنا الدير فإذا فيه أعظم إنسان جمالا وعيناه قد خلقا وأشده وثاقا مجموعة يداه إلى عنقه ما بين ركبتيه إلى كعبيه بالحديد. It said, I am Al-Jassasa. They said, what is Al-Jassasa? It said, oh people, go to this man in the monastery for he is keen to know about you. The narration said, when it named a man for us, we were afraid of it lest it being a devil. Then we set off, rushing until we came to the monastery where we found the cutest man we had ever seen, bound strongly in chains, with his hands tied to his neck and his legs bound from the knees to the ankles with iron jackals. قلنا ويلك ما أنت قال قد كدتتم على قبري فأخبروني ما أنتم قالوا نحن أناس من العرب ركبنا في سفينة بحرية فصادفنا البحر حين اغتنم فلعب بنا الموج شهرا ثم أرفأنا إلى جزيرتك هذه فجلسنا في أقربها فدخلنا الجزيرة فلقيتنا دابة أهنب كثير الشعر لا يدرى ما قبله من دبره من كثرة الشعر فقلنا ويلك ما أنت فقالت أنا الجساسة قلنا وما الجساسة قالت اعمدوا إلى هذا الرجل في الدير فإنه إلى قبركم بالأشواق فأقبلنا إليك سراعا وفزعنا منها ولم نأمن أن تكون شيطانة. We said, woe to you, who are you? He said, you will soon find out about me. Tell me who you are, they said. We are people from Arabia who embarked on a ship, but the sea became wild and the waves tossed us about for 1 month. Then they brought us to this island of yours. We took to the rowing boats and landed on this island. We were met by a beast with a great deal of hair, and we could not tell his front from his back because he was so hairy. We said, woe to you, what are you? It said, I am Al-Jassasa. They said, what is Al-Jassasa? It said, go to this man in the monastery, for he is keen to know about you. So we came rushing to you, and we fled from it because we could not be sure that it was not a devil. So we will stop here for today. And inshallah, next week we will complete the hadith of Tamim al-Dari and we will carry on with the remaining part of our discussion. وبإذن الله توفيقه.